In the halls of Inferno, roam the restless souls. The lone monarch approaches with the fire he controls. He's here to judge the wicked who sully his domain. To dab them with his rage to eternal pain. Swift as wind his punishment, absolute his reign. Dashing across a snowy plain, monsters nipping at the heel. Out of breath, limbs in pain, doomed to end as meal. One last stand, a final try, to die a hero's death. Then help arrives from the sky. Like a divine breath. Desolated ruins. A thief stalks through the mist. Driven by a lust for wealth, it just cannot resist. Begone, O foul miscreant. For these are sacred grounds. The dead dwell here. This is their realm. And you've overstepped its bounds. But other things live here as well, equally concealed. So be mindful of your insolence, lest your fate be sealed.
Wipe the land clean, so we may meet at last in paradise unseen.
Finally, the twain shall meet.
My queen, my queen! Smite the earth with your thunder. My king, let storm tear the clouds asunder. With lightning and hurricane, we sear and slice. For we are the architects of true paradise. Let us form our final bond to rule the world and all beyond.
Gaze up at the sky in fear. The crimson comet draws near. The light of the stars burns the earth to ash. Rends heaven in twain. With a final flash.
Those who let themselves be lured into the trap will be whisked away by a swift gale. The embodiment of darkness. A darkness that does not let its victims go, as they are slowly drained of their life. The servants keep providing their master with vital essence. And once the time is ripe, the darkness will show itself, basking in moonlight. Beasts find themselves in a place they don't belong. And when the master of this land appears, not even the mightiest attacks can do it any harm. With its overwhelming strength, it pummels and pins down its prey. Its endless anger fills the air in the form of a deafening roar as it prepares to feast without leaving a single bone. From the depth, its voice can be heard. The time has come. From the depth it beckons, come to me. As it feeds on stolen life, its power grows ever stronger. Until it finally reveals itself. When happening upon a frozen statue, its terrifying creator soon reveals itself. The Lord of the Tundra is heartless and cold, showering its prey in an impenetrable veil of snow, leading foolish creatures to an icy grave.